Hello, and welcome to another Lumbridge Knight guide for free-to-play OSRS. In this video, we're going to be looking at some intermediate and advanced mechanics to help you take your OSRS combat and training techniques to the next level. Welcome to the final part, at least for the moment, of my OSRS combat mechanics videos. This video aims to bring you some of the most effective intermediate to advanced combat and training techniques possible in OSRS. Mastering these techniques offers you a significant advantage in both PvE and PvP combat. We all know how to safe spot. It's easy enough. Stand behind a barrier or get your enemy stuck behind something, then use ranged or magic to take out your opponent in complete safety. Why then is it in my intermediate to advanced guide? Well, not all safe spotting is equal. Some enemies have to be manipulated into the correct position in order to become trapped and then able to be safe spotted. An easy low level example of this is the Count from Vampire Slayer. In order to safe spot this dude, we first have to lure him into one of the corners of the room, and then when he's in the right position, right click to walk into the same square. If you're lucky, he'll move into the correct position, and you can take a step to one side, and he'll be stuck in the corner, unable to fight back. If you're unlucky, you might have to repeat this step a few times. This technique can be deployed on multiple quests, and usually allows players with a much lower combat level to get through higher level quests and enemies. As mentioned in my previous videos, OSRS's game clock runs on a tick system, where one tick equals to 0.6 seconds. It is possible to manipulate or cheat the clock at times by chaining actions together that cancel out the usual action completion timer. This technique is significantly more click intensive, but can be incredibly powerful. There are a number of manipulations possible. Probably one of the simplest is tick eating. Tick eating can be used when you're being attacked by a certain ranged or magic. Basically, there's a delay between the damage shown being applied to your health and the game recognizing that you should have died. Thus, if you heal immediately before taking the damage, your health can never be reduced to zero, and you can survive attacks that should have killed you. Note that this doesn't work in PvP. Another useful tick-based trick is using combo eating. If you combine three tick-manipulatable foods, such as pizzas or karambrans, into a potion, you can achieve three actions in the space of a single action. In members, the ideal combo is any food, a sour brew, and a karambran. The equivalent in free-to-play is a pizza and any other food. Unfortunately, you can't do this in triplet like you can in members because there's no potions that provide healing in free to play. Probably the most useful areas to utilize tick manipulation is during skilling, as this can significantly increase the speed of certain tasks. For a full list and proper tutorial, I recommend looking at the OSRS wiki pages or some of the guides done by my fellow YouTubers. Unfortunately, most of the best methods here are limited to pay to play. I did find this guy doing 3-tick woodcutting, and it still seems to be valid. You can get the snow globe from Django in Draenor Village. Basically, he uses the gathering snow to cancel the woodcutting animation, so he starts by clicking the snow globe, then cuts wood, and clicks back to gather the snow and back to the tree, repeating this cycle periodically, stopping to drop wood and generate more snow. A better method might be this one, where he uses high alchemy to skip the woodcutting animation and manipulate the ticks.
Please like the video and support my content. Thank you, noble knight.
Prayer flicking is another technique that derives from tick manipulation. It's a very useful skill to master and can be used in most OSRS battles. It may be more useful in pay-to-play, but for Elvarg and PvP, prayer flicking is very effective in free-to-play as it gives you the ability to fight effectively against opponents of a much higher combat level. The first thing you need to do is set up your quick prayers. All you need to do is right click on the quick prayer icon next to your minimap, so right click, quick prayer setup, and in this instance we want to be using protect from missiles. Once that's done, we want to come off that menu and now we can toggle our prayers on and off by simply clicking this icon on the screen, as you can see my character doing. To help get my timings right, I use an online metronome. If you just search for metronome on Google, you can get that and set it to 100 beats per minute. This is roughly aligned to the game's clock. Since Obor has an attack speed of 6, this means he generally attacks on the 6th tick. I can align that now and I'll tune the metronome in so you can hear it. I then basically click prayer on the 4th or 5th tick and turn it off again on the 6th or just after. This basically preserves my prayer and allows me to have all the benefit while not actually using it. To do this, you will need to know the attack speed / frequency of your enemy. An alternative that's a lot more click intensive is one tick prayer flicking. This is done by clicking the prayer on and off again every tick. This gives you the protection of the prayer while not consuming any prayer points. As I said, it's very click intensive and easy to mess up your rhythm, but means you won't consume any prayer points if done right. Whichever way you prefer to prayer flick, practice is key. I recommend practicing both techniques on low level enemies until you build up your confidence and find your feet. Probably one of the most useful exploits in the combat system is flinching. If you have the patience, this technique can allow you to take out bosses and monsters that are of a much higher combat level. The key to this technique is to locate an area where you are still in an enemy's aggro, i.e. the monster's still trying to attack you, but you are sheltered from attack. Take the rocks in Elbarg's lair. You can see she is still targeting the player, but cannot attack slash deal damage to them. When you locate an area like this, then the possibility to flinch usually exists. So once you've got the aggro of the enemy in question, in this case Elbarg, all you need to do is wait for Elbarg's HP bar to disappear. Turn your rune on, turn auto retaliate off, and then click to attack her. Once you land a single blow, including a miss, run back behind the rock before she can retaliate. In other words, as soon as you see a hit or miss splash appear, click to run back behind the rock. Wait for her health bar to disappear again, and repeat the process. It will take time, you might have to let your run energy recover, and you still might take the occasional hit. But if you are quick and careful enough, you should be able to grind down a lot of difficult opponents in this way. Unfortunately, not all enemies will have spots in their lairs that allow for flinching. Equally, this technique is only useful for PvE, as clearly you can't flinch a player. Once again, practice is the key. The lesser demon in Melzar's maze is a good subject, as he drops aggro quite quickly when you use the safe area. So if you can master him, you should be pretty much good to go anywhere else. And that brings us to the end of this video. I hope that these intermediate to advanced techniques will serve you well out there in the world of Gelnor. Please leave a comment with any feedback or questions, as I'm keen to hear them. And all that's left for me to say is, I've been the Lumbridge Knight, peace out, and thanks for watching.